In our last lecture, we have seen that the sigma is a scattering cross-section. And this delta is a phase shift. So this is scattering cross-section sigma is dependent on the interaction between the neutron and the proton, and this phase shift delta is a change in phase of a neutron which is detected at the detector. Okay, so this phase shift, there is a change in phase of incoming wave function of a neutron, okay, with respect to the phase of the neutron which is detected in a detector. So this is the phase shift analysis for low energy NP interaction. So in last lecture we have seen the low energy NP interaction, and in the last lecture we have dealt with the few terms like scattering cross-section sigma and phase shift delta. This scattering cross-section sigma is dependent on NP interaction, and similarly this phase shift delta is also dependent on the interaction between the neutron and the proton. So this phase shift delta is the shift in phase of an incoming neutron and neutron which is scattered from this proton or from this hydrogen gas. There is a relation between the scattering cross-section sigma and the phase shift delta. For the energies lower than 1 MeV, so this also we have seen in the last lecture, for E less than 1 MeV, so the relation between the scattering cross-section sigma and the phase shift delta was given by 4 pi square upon k square sin square delta 0. Okay, so this is the relation between the scattering cross-section sigma and the phase shift delta for the energy less than 1 MeV. If we plot a graph of a phase shift delta with respect to energy of a neutron, so on this side y-axis there will be a phase shift delta, and this is the kinetic energy of a neutron. So if we plot a graph of this, we can see that, so this will be the nature of the graph. So this is called as a S is equal to, this is a singlet S wave. For this we can write S is equal to 0, L is equal to 0. This is called triplet S wave, and for this we can write S is equal to 1, L is equal to 0. And this is a P wave, for which we can write L is equal to 1. So the kinetic energy of the neutrons is in mega electron volts. Here I will write it somewhere 100. Here up to somewhere it is 300, 500 MeV. So this graph tells us that below 1 MeV, okay, so below 1 MeV or nearly 1 MeV will be somewhere here, and at this point we can see that below this 1 MeV only these S waves are contributing, okay, for which L is equal to 0, which means that below 1 MeV or for E less than 1 MeV, we can write that whatever scattering is there between this incoming neutron and this proton, then that scattering is isotropic. So I can write it here, the scattering is isotropic. It means that neutron can be considered to be scattered from the isotropic potential of the proton. It means that it will not consist of any central part. It will consist of only central part, and for that L is equal to 0. Means we know that L, if this L is equal to 1, it means that that potential consists of some non-central part. Okay. So when the energy of the neutron is less than 1 MeV, the neutron can be considered to be scattered from the isotropic potential. Okay, for that L is equal to 0. Okay, so if you increase the energy of the neutron, so here you can see that at the lower energies, up to the nearly 50 or 60 MeV, so this P wave starts to contribute. It means that so this neutron reaches to the proton so that their spins start interacting with each other. Means for this you can consider that this potential which is applied on this neutron, incoming neutron, that is not the central potential. And in this case, when this E is, I will write that greater than 1 MeV and which is less than 300 MeV. So for this energy, so neutron is nearing to the proton such that the proton potential is not central now. Okay, so they are nearing at a smaller distance so that their spins start to interact with each other. And the outcome or the phase shift at the detector will be dependent on the statistical probability. I will write here that term. Statistical probability of coupling between proton and neutron. Okay, so whatever phase shift delta is there, so that is due to the triplet S wave or singlet S wave or P wave and contribution of that. Okay, so if your energy is greater than 1 MeV and if it is lower than 300 MeV, then at that time the phase shift at the detector will be decided by the statistical probability of coupling between the protons and neutrons. So this, it means that this proton and neutron, so these are the spin half particles, and they will interact to give like S is equal to 1. So this S is equal to 1, this wave, so this state can be represented by three different waves, or three different states can give S is equal to 1. That's why it is called as a triplet S wave. So, and this quantum mechanically, they can be represented by, so this is two up spins, one half spin, one half spin. They will combine to form so as to give the spin 1, or two down spins. So this will be one state, this is another state, or it can be also written as one half spin up spin down plus spin down spin up. So these three states can give S is equal to 1. Therefore S is equal to 1 is a triplet S wave. Similarly S is equal to 0, only up down or down up, only this state can give S is equal to 0. Therefore it is called as a singlet S wave. So the statistical probability of coupling between the incoming neutron and the proton will decide the phase shift delta between the kinetic energies 1 MeV to 300 MeV. Okay. So let us see what happens if the energy is greater than 300 MeV. So if energy of the incoming neutron is greater than 300 MeV, so at that time, so the neutron this neutron reaches the proton so close that it is repelled by this neutron, or the repulsive potential is applied on the neutron and this neutron is scattered from the repulsive potential of the proton. In a nucleon-nucleon potential, we have seen that so after some distance the forces become repulsive. So this is the distance which is nearly 0.5 femtometer. If this is a potential well represented by a proton, or it is a proton potential well, so below 0.5 femtometer, if the neutron is having very high kinetic energy, and if it is reaching with this high amount of kinetic energy, if this neutron is capable of reaching this proton in the range of 0.5 femtometer, it is repelled by the proton, and there is a, so here in this case below 300 MeV there was an attractive potential of the proton applied on the neutron, but here the force will be the repulsive, which results in a change in sign of the phase shift delta. In this graph you can see that below 300 MeV the phase shift delta is positive, whereas above 300 MeV the phase shift delta is negative. So this is why below 300 MeV the potential of the proton was attractive, and above 300 MeV the potential applied by the proton on the neutron is a repulsive one. Below 1 MeV kinetic energy of a neutron, the potential applied by the proton was isotropic, for that L is equal to 0. So this is the central potential. It means that the neutron is scattered from the central potential. When the neutron is in the when the kinetic energy of the neutron is in the range of 1 MeV to 300 MeV, at that time the neutron reaches to the proton into 1.2 femtometers to 2 femtometer, and for this the neutron is scattered by the attractive potential of the proton, whereas if the kinetic energy of the neutron is greater than 300 MeV, the neutron is repelled by the potential of the proton and it reaches the distance nearly of the 0.5 femtometers. So this is how the phase shift delta depends on the kinetic energy of the neutron. And once you can calculate this phase shift delta, you can calculate the scattering cross section sigma. Previously we have seen that this phase shift delta changes its sign nearly at a 300 MeV. So nearly at a 300 MeV, so this phase shift delta changes its sign. Okay, so for the energy less than 300 MeV, this delta is positive, and below this means about 300 MeV, so this delta is negative. This change in sign of the delta can be represented by using the square well potential. We know that the square well potential supplied by any proton or a neutron can be represented by this diagram. So here is a V of R, this is a R, and here is the kinetic energy of a neutron. Suppose this is a region 1 and this is region 2. Suppose if u of 1 is given by a sine of kr, and where k is equal to square root of 2m v naught plus e upon h cross square. And u2 is given by, I will take another c, sine of small kr plus delta, where this is small k is 2me upon h cross square. So in this diagram, u1 is the wave function of a neutron which is coming, so which is a sine kr, and u2 is the potential of the same neutron which is detected in a detector. So this is the incoming neutron and this is the neutron detected in a detector. So this is a wave function of the neutron detected in a detector with a phase shift delta. Okay, and this is the wave function of a neutron which is about to interact with the proton, and the potential field of the proton is represented by a square well potential. Okay, so in this case, this is the attractive potential. I will write it here. So how it represents the attractive potential? So this is the kinetic energy of a neutron which is above the potential energy, which is greater than the potential energy of a proton, and afterwards it is decreased. So the total energy is decreased from this to this. It means that this proton is attracting the neutron so that the kinetic energy of the neutron is reduced. So this is the symbolic representation of an attractive potential wave. Okay, similarly, repulsive square well potential can be represented by like this. So this is the kinetic energy of a neutron, or the total energy of the neutron. So at the start, the energy of the neutron was less, and afterwards it is increased. It means that this potential wave is a representation of a repulsive potential or the repulsive force, in which we can see that the energy of the neutron is increased. It means that this proton is repelling the neutron. So this is a symbolic representation of a repulsive potential wave. So in this case, suppose this is a region 1, this is region 2. In the region 1, you have a potential of this kind, and this is the potential of the kind which is at the distance r very very greater, or r nearly equals to infinity, or it is a wave function for the neutron detected in a detector with the phase shift delta. Suppose if the capital K is greater than the small k, in this case capital K is greater than this small k here, so the wave function of this u1 can be represented by this dotted line. So this will be u of 1 and this will be u of 2, and in this case, this is phase shift delta can be given by k of r2 minus r1. So this is r1 and this is r2. So for this, as r2 is greater than r1, this phase shift delta is positive. For the repulsive potential, I will write u of 1 is a sine of capital Kr, where u2 is a c sine of small kr plus delta. So here k is different than the attractive potential, which is 2m E minus V naught. So this is V naught. In this case, this is V naught. So E minus V naught upon H cross square, and the small k is the same, which is 2m E upon H cross square. So in this case, when this k is small, k is greater than capital K, here if I draw a sine function, so this is u2, and if this capital K is less than so this will be r2, this will be r1, and in this case delta can be given by k r1 minus r2. As this r1 is smaller than r2, we can write that delta is negative. So this is how we can explain this phase shift delta by using the square well potential. So before 300, means below 300 MeV, these neutrons are scattered by the attractive potential. This is a representation of the attractive potential, and in this case this delta is positive, whereas above the kinetic energy of the 300 MeV, so this neutron is supposed to be scattered by the repulsive potential. This is a symbolic representation of the repulsive potential, and in this case the delta comes out to be nearly negative. So for a repulsive potential, the delta is negative, and for the attractive potential, delta is positive. So this is how the phase shift delta is explained with the help of a square well potential.